Call to order the special call meeting of the Winfield City Council at 4:00. Are there any amendments to the agenda? If not, the agenda will stand as written and as posted. We have no old business action items, no old business non-action items. We have two new business action items. The first is a motion to adopt the proposed 17 and 18 budget. I just want to try to clarify a few things concerning the budget. One that's been going around, the rec department is not being closed. We will have to make some changes in the recreation department somewhat with some of the programs. We need more volunteer help to try to maintain some of the programs like the flag football referees and the LYBA referees and some things like that. We need some people to step up and do some volunteer refereeing to help us with that. That's just, doesn't sound like a lot, but it all adds up during the year. We're going to try to maintain a recreation program. My goal in this budget is to try to do the least damage as far as reducing our reserve funds because of the not being able to get the proposed needed increases in our utility, electric utility primarily to help pay or to pay this bonded indebtedness that we have and was incurred to build a new substation. I've been asking for increases now for 2 years. This would be the third year, and could not get them for this year, so we tried to make associated cuts to try to adjust for that. My priority is to keep the lights on, water running, sewer running, and have the best police and fire protection we can have with the budget we can work with. Everything else has to, take the cuts if possible. We've got it, and then a budget is a guide. It's something you propose and put forth for the year. Things change. Hopefully our revenue will not change for the worst. It'll be as we project, but you never know for sure. And we, unexpected expenses occur, and that's that you have to take care of, and that's why you have to have some reserves. So that's what we're trying to do for this year. We're going to do our best to manage everyone's money, or the people's money, as best we can with what we have and maintain some reserves by the end of the year. But the animal shelter is still not in this budget. That was something that was not, that was cut out. And we did have some layoffs last week, and those will stand. And then hopefully there won't be any more through the coming year. But we'll just have to adjust as we go along if we have to. And like I said, the essential services of the city are the most, get top priority. And that's what this budget was trying to be modeled around. So.
So, Mayor, I just didn't ask, there's been one around at the Refuge Foundation grant for the rec is still in the budget.
It is, a portion of it.
Okay.
The entire grant was $300,000. And there is still, in this year's budget, $125,000. Which 100 would be the Rapids grant, and then we have to match, we have to put in 25.
We've only gotten 50,000 year to date on that grant, because once he is projected to come back and
arrive, he
should be
doing something after he has happened to appoint an agency. So once we get the plan back, then we'll give it to move forward as far as going down.
We took bids on the bathrooms, and the rec board met. And the bids that we got, we only got two bids. And the recreation board and myself included, we felt like they were high. And so we're gonna try to go back out for bids again. on the bathrooms, and see if we can get a better bid to get those done. But, you know, we're trying to follow what Rapids, the Rapids Foundation has instructed us to do concerning this grant. They're the ones that gave us the use of a man from North Carolina to try to help us develop, do the surveys and develop a plan or a longer range plan for the city, which could include the parish. And, because the parish uses the city recreation program. And he is to come back at the end of July and have a town hall or a public meeting and give the results of those surveys and talk about, that, get some more input. But it's all, we're all trying to follow the Rapids Foundation guidelines, or what they have suggested for us to do.
It'll be here the week of July 24th.
That's right, the week of July 24th. So, but we do have that in the budget to try to spend a portion of that grant in this year. Any more?
Because I've been asked about saying that, the lights gonna be turned off and.
The lights being turned off?
Yeah. Right, but you're not gonna pay.
What? If we get the budget passed today.
And of course, we can handle it.
This would be under the amended budget.
Okay.
But no, we're not, that was another rumor.
Okay.
Or whatever. We did purchase electricity and we have to pay for it. So that was part of the possibility. If we didn't pass the budget and went to 50%, then, the big question was, is that 50% in the utility fund also? If that's the case, then we can only buy half the power we bought this past year. And I don't see how that could work, so.
My question is, at this point, this budget, should we adopt it? We are, the cuts we've made so far, that's it, we can operate from here forward without any drastic cuts.
Well, unless something changes, a budget is a guide.
Yeah, it was to go down.
If something happens, you know, we might have to make some adjustments, you know, 3 months or 6 months in or something like that.
But as of right now.
Hopefully not, yes.
I guess my next question is, have we met with our department head that they went over the budget that, you and Susan put together as far as the money?
Yes.
Mine's more just a comment, you know, or two that I'd like to make. Of course, I want to thank everyone for being here. We're paid to do a job here, and it's good that citizens hold us accountable to those responsibilities. I've received a lot of calls and texts and messages, and it's always good for us to hear the feedback, and it's always good to see participation from the community. My main concern is the path that we're on with our budget as far as depleting our reserves. I'm just not comfortable with that, and as a path to travel down for any extended period of time. And I'm told that we are using our reserve funds to the tune of an average of about $77,000 a month, and this is just to make ends meet. That worries me. And that brings me to my next point, is that that is not a sustainable financial path for us to be on. You know, we either need to continue drastic cuts in order to balance our budget, or we need to explore other options that would generate additional revenue to continue to provide the essential services to our citizens that are expected. We need animal control. I mean, there's no question about it that we need that service. We need police and fire protection. And we need to be able to pay and attract qualified, good applicants to our police and fire departments and be able to pay a pay rate that keeps them here, that keeps them in Winfield. And we have some great people that work for our fire department, our police department. They do a phenomenal job, and I'm proud of our people. But they deserve more pay. Our city employees do a phenomenal job in maintaining our streets, our water, and our sewer systems, and they all deserve a pay rate that, that will keep them here. And so those are concerns, and, you know, I don't want to look at, you know, the options of raising rates, but, I mean, we're at the point to where we need to begin the conversation on how we are able to continue providing the services to the citizens that they expect. And it just concerns me using our reserve funds and staying on that path for any long period of time. Independent auditors find that we are on an unsustainable financial path. So that's a concern. And so I'm glad that we are able to come back to the table to address our budget concerns, but hopefully we will be able to continue to address, you know, our financial problems, because we need the services that we provide.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Miller. I echo those sentiments. But the task at hand right now is that, to pass this proposed 17-18 budget. So I need a motion for a resolution to pass this. A motion by Miller. Do I have a second?
Second.
Second by Junkin. I'm going to call for the vote. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries unanimously. Okay, the second new business action item is a motion to adopt the amended 16-17 budget, which we need to make an amendment in it so we can move a little bit more money out of the sales tax fund that we need to pay some year-end bills, which will be tomorrow. And it's about $263,000 that we'll move out of the sales tax fund and other reserves to finish up this year. And the 15-16 is at the auditor right now.
16-17
will be sent to them in
September.
We'll have to get everything closed out.
It's
the
16-17. I'm so confused. It's been so many. 15-16 is at the auditor's data. They expect to have it complete by August.
16-17
will be done. We have sales tax lags 2 months behind, so we'll get the June revenue in August. And then they'll send as soon as that we get that in.
But it's not due really.
It's got to be in by December 31st.
December 31st.
Okay. So, do I have a motion to adopt the amended 16-17 budget? I have a motion by Demery.
Second.
Second by Miller. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries unanimously. We have no new business non-action items. That concludes our business for today. I appreciate the turnout. I hope everyone that's here, if you have any questions concerning the, you can call me, talk to me. Concerning this, it's good that citizens get more involved. It's a shame, I guess, that it takes a maybe a near crisis to cause that. But the city is not broke. But as Mr. Miller said, we're headed on the path that something's got to change, and we're going to try to make through this year and as best we can, by maintaining the best services that we can under the circumstances. And we'll have to make adjustments during the year possibly, but hopefully nothing will be too drastic. And And I want to tell the city employees that are still with the city that we're going to do everything we can to maintain that. And I appreciate the effort that they all put forward, from the police department, the fire department, the utility department, and even the rec department and streets. They're all trying to do a job. And so if that's all that we have, then for today, then I need a motion to adjourn. I have a motion by Demery, second by Junkin. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
For adjourn.